हेलो नमस्ते, दिस इज़ मौना रामचंद्रा, अ डिसाइपल ऑफ श्रीमती वीणा सहस्रबुद्धे जी. एंड रागमाला एंड श्रीवाणी जडे हैव आस्क्ड मी टू स्पीक अबाउट वीणाताई एंड रिकॉल सम इंसिडेंट्स अबाउट हर. सो आई सेड आई विल स्पीक अबाउट द 2001 कॉन्सर्ट दैट शी डिड फॉर रागमाला इन सियाटल. I'll speak about the planning of that concert and the structure and how that concert was, you know, the some stories about that. So in that concert, Veenataayi has presented three ragas, Rag Shri, Rag Marubihag and Rag Jokkaus. So now about Shri, the story is that, you know, a Pandit Divi Paluskar ji, he has immortalized Harike Charana Kamala with his recording, and perhaps that was one of the, you know, complete raga recordings in a longer format, because the other recordings he's done were for, you know, sort of 3 minutes, and this recording had a very, very, you know, a very big impact on Veenataayi. And she said, Shri gana hai to aise hi gana hai, you know, you have to sing Shri just in this form. And she, of course, she learnt various other bandishes, but along the way then she stuck to this template of singing a sort of madhya vilambit lay jhaptal harike charana followed by two other compositions. So in a way I think Shri was her tribute, and she always sang it in that mood of, you know, surrender to possibly Pandit D.V. Paluskar ji. Then she sang Marubihag. Now, Marubihag was not a rag she sang very frequently, because Bihag and Yaman, these ragas, you know, she would choose to sing quite a bit. And of course, you can't sing Marubihag after that. So, but there's a very, you know, sort of sweet incident about Marubihag that she recalls, and she says, what she sings in Marubihag is Patiya le jao Pranava Piya ke paas. Now Pranava Piya is Pandit Omkarnath Thakur ji. So she recalls, and this is her childhood memory, that Pandit Omkarnath Thakur ji used to live in Banaras, and he had a car in the 1950s that he would drive all the way from Banaras to Gujarat where he lived. So Kanpur was a natural halt, and he stayed with Veenataayi's father, and because he was a Sanskrit scholar, he used to speak in, apparently I believe, in that Sambodhan form, and he used to call her Veenay. And she remembers as a child him having like very shiny long hair that used to shake when he spoke, you know, that used to move. So she used to recall this all the time, and, you know, say, and I think she's also sang a Dhrut composition by Pandit Balwant Rai Bhatji, who is a disciple of Pandit Omkarnath Thakur. So the final raga she chose is Rag Jokkaus. Now she had an ideal person, ideal artist for every rag, and Srimati Manik Verma ji was a huge ideal when she sang Jokkaus. So she says, and she used to say, that when she first performed, when she performed Jokkaus once, Pandit C.R. Vyas ji was sitting in the audience, and Pandit C.R. Vyas ji's guru has composed this raga Jokkaus. And so what she says is, he after the concert came and said, you know, Areva, this is our raga, and how come you've sung it so well? Where did you learn from? But of course she didn't have an answer. And she didn't say anything, so she said she just smiled at him because she picked this up herself. So there are three beautiful compositions, the last one being a composition of Pandit Vasant Thakar ji, her guru, who's composed a beautiful Iktal Dhrut composition. So of course she sang three ragas, three bandishes in every raga. So there's, you know, very quickly I'll tell you the story of three bandishes, because in just one generation before Veenataayi, there were these great masters who carved out such a big place for themselves in this field of Hindustani classical music, and they used to sing the विलंबित कॉम्पोजिशन, स्लाइटली स्लोअर, इन अ स्लोअर टेम्पो दैन ट्रेडिशनल. एंड ऑन द अदर साइड व्हेन दे सैंग द्रुत, बिकॉज दे वॉन्टेड टू सिंग फास्टर तांस एंड इवन फास्टर तांस, द टेम्पो ऑफ द द्रुत वुड बी वेरी वेरी फास्ट. सो इफ दे वर, जस्ट टू गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल, इफ इट वॉज 4 second gap between two beats in the vilambit, like dhin, dhin. On the other side, there was a drut which, you know, the whole 16th cycle of tintal was literally in 4 seconds. So there was so much contrast. So she just wanted a sort of landing platform or a, you know, restful mood. She wanted to bring back that restful mood in her performances. So she chose to always sing this Madhyalaya composition. And also because she, of course, liked lyrics very much, and she thought that, you know, can bring out the bhav and of the words. And she always used to say this, that to bring out the feel and to, you know, give importance to these lyrics, and so that the audience also enjoys these wonderful lyrics that great composers have written. So she thought she should include Madhyalaya to bring out those facets that she could do with her voice and with her music. Yeah, please do go ahead and listen to all these recordings that will be released on YouTube. And thank you so much, Dr. Ramesh Gangoli ji and Shrivani, for letting me speak. Thank you.